when the crack appears, we're thinking about to make concrete to have the same function to be able to heal the crack automatically like our human body. As an inventor, the technology is like my baby. I really want to see it grow properly and being used in a right way in the industrial world. I'm Dr. Liz Zijing Li. I'm the COO, inventor, and co-founder of Mimicrate. Mimicrate is a startup working on sustainable and resilient construction material through self-healing technology. We're able to expand the lifespan of the construction infrastructure, but also make the structure be more able to react to the monitoring system, so then we can avoid monitoring repair cost afterwards and also to reduce carbon emission of the life cycle. As we all know that concrete is not perfect, it often cracks. And when the crack appears, normally we need to send engineers to fix the cracks. But the procedure is really low efficient and high cost. And this is actually leading to concrete as the world's most destructive materials. Around 8% of carbon emission is related with concrete product. I would say it's very high priority to have a consulting session with the IP or legal firm to talk about what you can protect, at least understanding what is actually protectable. And then once you know that, maybe to try to understand how much budget you have and when you're able to protect your IP or patent or trademarks, etc.
As a patent attorney, I help businesses to protect their innovation through patents and help them to preserve their competitive advantage in the market. There wasn't a concrete plan, but she had the knowledge of patents from previous course that she'd been on and knew that they would be important to her business. So the initial advice I gave was to help her understand what might be protectable before deciding whether to go ahead with filing a patent or not.
So after that, I have this basic knowledge with Joel, and then think about actually, we need a patent, and then we need to actually draft the patent and submit it properly.
As a patent attorney, I have to ask the right questions of my clients to try and get the information I need to assess whether there is innovation there that's protectable that we haven't yet protected. Liz and I have quite regular meetings to catch up on any prosecution matters for the patents she's already filed, but also to understand more broadly what's happening within the business and to try and identify opportunities to strengthen their IP portfolio or to mitigate any IP-related risks that might crop up. Many startups need investment. Often it's because it's highly research intensive, requires a lot of capital up front before you get to revenue. It's all intangible, so protecting that early on is basically essential. Patents are definitely assets to the business. They're there to be leveraged to gain commercial advantage, but they're not something just to pin up on the wall.